Hey guys, Iron Phoenix here, which you'll probably know since you come across my channel. Hello! And hello all you new people who haven't actually found me before and you found me now. So, hi, I'm Iron Phoenix, I do video tutorials mostly, and for the past few tutorials I've been saying, yeah, I'll show you what I've actually been doing. And I haven't, so this is a video to say hello, this is what I've been doing. But first, let me talk to you about ideas, because everybody has them. Everybody has ideas for games, music videos, films, whatever. And it's a little bit daunting to start off with, because you don't know how to do it. I toyed with a lot of different programs to get to the ones that I use now, which are GIMP for my texture editing. Then I use Blender for my 3D modelling and Unity for as my actual engine. The way that I see it is you've got three engines pretty much to choose from when you're starting out your game, or starting out trying to work out what to make your game in. You've got Source, UDK and Unity. Source engine, it's quite scalable. It's loved by many people for quite a long time. The only thing that I will say is that the tools are a little basic. I've said this before in previous tutorials, and just of general complaints. In fact, I think in my last one about the Portal 2 editor, all the points that I made there are still true today, to me anyway. It's very basic, it's quite old. The tools are really, really, especially when you start looking at other editors such as Unity here and Unreal Editor. Unreal Editor is the development kit that's been released by Epic, and it's completely free until you actually start wanting to release something that people might pay for, and it's a complete editor, so it contains your particle tools, model importation, materials importation, everything you need. The only thing that it doesn't have in it is a UI editor that got taken out in a previous release, and they've moved completely now to Scaleform, so you'll need some access to some kind of Flash program to make UIs with, and any kind of scripting tools. That's also done. You'll need sort of Visual C++ to make your to do your scripts, and then it's a little bit iffy to kind of get things working in it. Again, it kind of falls into a little bit the same trap as Source, in that it's not particularly easy to necessarily set things up to work. Which is why I love Unity, because it's so simple. It's the one that's worked for me the best so far. So if I want to import a texture, I can either use the importation tools, import new asset, or I can just shove it in the assets directory and it will just automatically import in here. Everything you need is actually in it. So it's got a particle editor, it's got a scripting tool as well. So if I just open up Missile Silo, it will take a little bit of time, but as it comes up, it for me this was the best tool for me to use. So this is the tool that I'm using, and I think the message that I really have for everyone that's they're looking at mapping, they're looking at making their own games, if you've got an idea, just go for it. You've got nothing to lose by going for it. And in fact, if you're put off by the fact that you might have to learn JavaScript, for example, which is what I've had to learn, I've got to this point in 3 weeks. I've got a fully functioning game to my own standards. So yeah, just go for it, learn things. If you've got any questions about the things I'm going to about to show you what I've been doing, dump them in comments below. For now, let's actually go to the game, because hey, that's why I made this video. So if I just bring up Unity. So this is flattest, which is basically the map where I've been testing all my little bits and pieces. So here I've got Village Totem. I've got an iron ingot here, which isn't actually attached to anything yet. That's a pile of snow, and that's a building, and you kind of get the idea. There's all sorts of things lying around, so I'm just going to hit play. So here we have the environment. Now, frozen earth, or frozen skies it will eventually be, is currently a single player winter survival game. So think a little bit more harsh than Minecraft. That's what I'm aiming for. I have kind of got a multiplayer planned, but I'm not quite sure quite how that's going to go yet. So for now, it's single player. Current plan is for it to be a free release, as in you won't have to pay anything for single player at all. Again, that might change. I don't know quite what's going on yet with it. So for now though, this is heavily an alpha. This is the first alpha that I've shown anyone. So let's get down to it. So while you're outside, this bit doesn't actually work yet, but as you're outside, you'll constantly be losing heat. And eventually that will start taking a toll on your health, slowing you down, causing damage. There are ways to counter this by putting on clothes, by staying inside as much as you can. As soon as you're inside, you're out of the wind, you're not going to be doing so much, you're not going to be cooling down so much. And by standing near a campfire as well. In fact, the campfire will reverse the effects and heat you up. Then we have an inventory system, which I just showed you kind of a bit there. Again, it's all very up in the air, but that's actually meant to be a mug. And if I walk over to some snow here, hit I can then craft a hot drink, which will end up there, and that will heat me up, as shown there. Skill pane is controlled by skill books, which is here. Pick up a skill book, and you can, sorry, that's the wrong one. You can then choose a skill, so navigation 1. Navigation is put into your map. So if you've got no navigation skills at all, that will just be a white background. And then as you get more skills into navigation, it will build up the map layer by layer. So that's sort of your hill layer there. And then there's additional layers, a buildings layer and an infrastructure layer as well. I've got village. So the idea of village is you can stick things in your inventory and then build buildings in the village circumference. You can either drop, again this isn't quite coded in, this is a planned feature, you can drop these village totems here and then you can rename it as whatever you like. Town. And then that will remain there as your village name. The other thing, you'll, again, planned feature, you'll be able to claim buildings. So you'll be able to say, okay, I want that building as my town hall. So you'll be able to click on it using claim building. And then that will become your town hall. And it will gain all the benefits of a town hall, or a chicken farm, or a cow farm, or whatever you like, really. Build menu, again this is a little bit broken at the moment. That's meant to be a watchtower, but it doesn't quite work at the moment. So yeah, this is what I've been doing for all this time, not making tutorials and not making any maps, and that's the missile silo. It's in heavy work in progress. Got a toolbar down the bottom for your various tools as you build them. That'll appear down there, and you'll be able to do things. So hammer is used for building buildings. Then I think screwdriver is planned to make things like turrets. I can't remember what all the different ones are, but yeah. I've got traps, factories, missile silos, all kinds of crazy things. So yeah, this is what I've been doing. When I started this project, I had no idea what I was doing. But as I did things, as I learned how to code more and more things, it became easier. All this obviously will be textured, bump mapped. You'll be able to pick things up, you'll be able to craft things. These down here are health packs, so you can use things. You can also, sorry, it's a little bit bug, you can also take them, which will then appear in the. And sorry, that number there is your weight. Not quite sure why it's on 1.2.5, there's probably some errors in the code somewhere. But yeah, so this is what I've been doing. If you've got any ideas for games that you want to make, find yourself a perfect setup of which programs you want to use for each thing, and then just get out there, do it, make things, because in the end, the idea isn't doing any good stuck in your head. Get it out there. If it's a flop, then it's a flop. You haven't lost anything and you've gained quite a lot. So get out there, do it. And little point, try and use a proper engine. Things like FPS Creator and Game Maker, they're all very well and good, but it's not really, it's not a very good way to get your game out there. So ignore Three Clicks Philip with his FPS Creator thing. If he wants to do that, that's fine. Personally, I quite like Unity. So, I mean, I've got 3D buildings and things. So, yeah, all's good. Video done. Again, comments, questions, anything. Comments about hamsters or cats or why you think fish is better than totem poles. Shove it all down there. The more mad, the better. So, go wild. Make games. Get out there. Do it.